We just start by hands off everybody who's heard of the Industrial Strategy Challenge Fund. Hurrah, this is good news. A little bit of background. You will remember in the autumn statement last year, 4.7 billion was put into the Industrial Strategy Challenge Fund. Not all of that money has been spent, but some of it has been allocated in three areas. Who can tell me what those three areas are? Robotics and autonomous systems, robotics in hazardous environments, good. Number two, batteries, improved battery technology, lighter, longer, recyclable, and?
Pharmaceuticals manufacturing, isn't it?
Yeah, brilliant. So this is good. So these are the three that have already been done. And?
We're the innovators board, Ruth.
Yes.
We know the answers.
Good, right. Okay, here's the harder one. What are the next ones?
I know some of them.
We don't know what they are, is the answer. So you might know what you want, but we don't know what they are.
What do you want, John?
I've seen a piece of paper with something on
there. There are some. So I will just take you to where we are today. So having announced the first three and some additional sort of pathfinder pieces of work, the job now is to look at what we're calling wave two. So what are the next challenges that we really want to try and solve, and challenges that will create economic growth in the UK, that will help develop the businesses of the future, that will set us up for the fourth industrial revolution. And this is quite a big job. So we started out, some of you may remember, you probably were there, at roundtable discussions in January of last year. Then we had all of the submissions, 2,000 of them, to the Green Paper. We have actually been going through them in partnership with our colleagues at FASE, really looking for new ideas and things that are coming out. And then within UK Research and Innovation, ourselves and the research councils, we've been pulling together the next 9 or 10 ideas, which once we've got agreement from government that these are the sorts of things they want, we will then have a big engagement in each of those areas with industry. Now, they are challenge-led. So we have adopted some of the technology, some of the ideas of DARPA. This is not business as usual. This is not how research councils operate. It's not how Innovate UK operate. We will have challenge directors who are really responsible for overseeing how these challenges are delivered, and they have to be a challenge of the type of, I'm just going to make this up now. My background's in neuroscience. How do we ensure that people with mental health illness are kept out of hospital, with reducing hospital days by 50% and reducing time off work by 50%? You know, a real challenge. And the answer to that challenge is interdisciplinary. And many of those challenges will have an AI element. So what I really want to ask of you today is, don't think about the technology, don't think about artificial intelligence or machine learning or the math or the big data being what you do. Think about how it can be applied to a challenge that will develop economic growth in the UK, by which we mean higher quality jobs, more prosperous businesses around the UK. It has to connect to what people want and need. That's my 5 minutes. Does everybody understand where we're going here?
Any
questions?
Any burning questions, Ruth? It was a bit less than 5 minutes. You're more like 3.5, actually.
Really?
Yeah.
I always think I talk a long time.
You did bloody well there, we thought. Question for any questions, any points?
Go.
What's your time frame for delivering results? 1 year, 5 years, 10 years?
Okay, good. So the money, the 4.7 billion, is to be spent between now and 2021. So that time frame. The first three were announced around about March, April, weren't they? And we are expecting that there will be sort of a drumbeat of announcements of the next ones as they're validated, and we've got a good idea September onwards. But really, we're looking for things that are going to have impact in the next 3-4 years. They might not be solved, but they really need to have impact. We need to understand who are the businesses that are going to take on this research knowledge, the innovation, the AI, the big data, going to assimilate all of this and start growing businesses. So if it's not going to deliver something in the next 3 to 4 years, it's probably not right. So don't come proposing some artificial intelligence for designing new molecules that might be drugs in 15 years' time. Not going to work. Okay.
So you want us to use our, during the course of today and beyond, to use our collective intelligence to make either individually or collectively DARPA-type bids as a grand challenge?
Well, the ideas are already in formulation, and what I would like is, which areas do you think AI will be most impactful? Is it the future of services, services 4.0? Is it the future of, you know, social care? Is it the future of helping the elderly? Is it the future of housing? All of those things, because there will be an AI element, in my view, to all of them. And then in September, when we come to do the deeper dives with industry, it would be fantastic if the companies represented here would be able to pitch up at the appropriate deep dives and go, actually, we can contribute something to solving this problem.
Yeah.
Okay?
Thank you very much. That's very helpful indeed. Next up is Jacques Kelly. Where are you, Jacques?